Hey YouTube, what's up? It's your boy Dorfers, and welcome back to my 316 Liverpool Corner Vlog. And I just don't know. I don't know. This season is over, okay? This is gonna be another rant commentary over the Liverpool Corner Vlog reveal. I'm sorry, but I just have to get it. The players we have are just shit. And if any team anywhere is even considering Brendan Rodgers for a managerial position at any point in the future, don't do it. Don't do it. He will leave you a crumpled mess. And I don't want to put the blame on Jurgen Klopp. He hasn't brought in his players yet. Next season will hopefully be better, but this season is over. It's over, because we're not going to beat Dortmund, especially if we can't hold a goddamn 2-0 lead. And this is the second goddamn time that this has happened. And this is the second time this has happened in 2016. And it seems to be against the teams that start with S. Are we going to do this against Spurs as well? But when we play them for the second match? Because if so, let's just give Spurs the point now and save us all a lot of fucking time. Let's just do that. Because I am sick and tired of watching this shit. And there's nothing we can do about it until summer. We need fierce improvement. And it's just not good enough. We cannot. It seems like the team, when they get a lead, they try to sit back, but our defense isn't good enough. I mean, when your goalkeeper is Simon Mignolet, you cannot rest on any lead. No matter what time it is in the match. Half time. So, final score 3-2. And I'll give Mignolet his credit. If not for him, it would have been 4-2 because he saved the penalty. And I'm not trying to this Southampton. I didn't see the match. That's because it wasn't on TV. But I'm going to give Southampton the benefit of the doubt that they probably deserve to win. If they could have had 4 and we only scored 2, then that is our own fault. But I can guarantee, without even having seen 1 second of the match, I can tell you why. Liverpool went 2-0 up, as you guys know. But I guarantee you, what happened is they got 2-0 up. Maybe they went in search of maybe goal number 3 for a while, you know, got a bit unlucky, and all of a sudden, bang, 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 they get hit with goals out of nowhere, or sometimes they drop off and just don't give a shit, and the goals come as they are expected, and have been coming all game. That is pretty much how we can sum up any Liverpool game this whole season. It's pathetic and crap, and I hope they're not on TV for the rest of the season, because I don't want to watch them. I don't want to watch any more collapses. I don't want to watch it. I really don't. It's pathetic. Our attack, if we finished our chances, our attack would probably be good enough to be in the top 4, if not challenging for the title. If our defense wasn't, I was going to say, League 2 bad, but League 2 teams are probably laughing at how bad our defense is. Aston Villa are probably laughing at how bad our defense is. I mean, at least when you're asked if I support Aston Villa, I'd go into a match expecting to lose, and not expect the team to go up by 2 goals at halftime, and at the end of the match, have it end up losing 3-2. Villa fans don't have to worry about that. They could, because they go into matches expecting to lose, because they've been that bad this season. But I guarantee you, if Aston Villa were asked to swap defenses with us tomorrow, they wouldn't do it. They would not do it. They wouldn't swap up their defense for ours. I guarantee it.
There goes the cross.
So really, that is the main thing we need to improve on in the summer. While yes, we need players in other positions, because really the whole team just isn't good enough, especially if we're going to be challenging the top four, and if we want to keep Jurgen Klopp's promise of maybe challenging for a title inside 3 years, there's a reality, then we're going to have to pick a better defense as well, because you don't win this league with a bad defense. Just ask Man City. Without Vincent Kompany, they have fallen away.
Well, in this FA Cup time.
Now, I don't know what the final score was in the Manchester derby. But even if City did win today, they're still not going to win the league. They are out of the title race. And they are so desperate. They're bringing in freaking Pep Guardiola. But the team they have now, even with a mediocre and a shit manager in Manuel Pellegrini, City should be walking the league like they were at the start of the season. But they dropped off because Kompany keeps getting injured. And without Kompany, the City defense is terrible.
He's out of danger. He's got his shot off now. He's kept it out. Throw with a bit of urgency about it.
Seriously. Demichelis and Bangala, are probably the only two center backs who could make our defenders look good. Because most of the time they're pathetic.
It goes out wide again. It's cut out the pass, intercepting if you like, and now can go on the attack maybe.
So that's my take on today's match. You're terrible. We need to improve. And summer can't come fast enough.
And that has opened the scoring. 1-0 here.
Today's result dashes any hopes of us getting even Europa League. We're not even going to be in the Europa League next season. So we're going to be in the same basket as Manchester United, watching Man City buy every player under the sun again. I'm wondering, can we maybe sign a decent player? Oh, you want Champions League football? Oh, we don't have that. We don't even have a Europa League. So, yeah, that's what we have to look forward to. I don't even know if Jurgen Klopp can
coming up on
bring in players.
For Liverpool.
I mean, I want to believe that Jurgen Klopp can bring in good players on his on the fact that he's a good manager and everyone knows he's a good manager.
Well, the threat was there. It wasn't quite the goal. I think the keeper might
to be honest,
Martin, because I don't think he would have got there.
What? Even if he could convince good players to come, which he probably could still, but what good player would look at Liverpool right now and say, yeah, I want to go play for them. Sitting in mid-table. Because that's where we've gone. We're mid-table. I didn't want to accept it, but Jamie Carragher, what he said earlier, was right. We have turned into Spurs. Spurs have turned into an amazing team, and we've become the shitty team that spends all their money on useless players and gets no results. Right? It was a change in manager. When they brought, now that under Pochettino, you know, Spurs are good. Spurs are finally showing what they can do. And you can bet that they're going to improve. Even if they don't win the title this season, they will improve. And they'll be one of the top couple of teams for the next couple of seasons. If not, fighting tooth and nail to get the title. And that's if they don't win it this season, which they still have a chance to. Because last time I saw the Earth match, it was 2-0 to them over Bournemouth. So, unless Bournemouth pulled off an amazing comeback as well, I'm going to take a wild guess that Spurs won that match. So, really, it's between Spurs and Leicester for the Premier League title. And to be honest, I was hoping that Man City would win the title, just because I don't want to see Sterling win the title. And while, like, I didn't expect the title winners to be, Leicester or frickin', Spurs, then, but yeah, they are. And I'm cool with that. You know, go for it. It'd be good to see who no one expected them win. Maybe Leicester or Spurs, whichever it ends up being, maybe he whoever wins can inspire Liverpool. That's the final whistle. Because Lord knows, those shitheads that call themselves Liverpool football club players, they need all the inspiration they can fucking get. Because they are terrible. So yeah, beat Northampton 3-0, now I'm going to get into the Spurs game, which is kind of poetic because I was just talking about them, so why not? why the hell not? Lineups are probably what you expect.
Defenders. Gareth Bale starts with Marco Reus in the wide positions, and a partnership with these two strikers up front.
My second teamer is too tired to play again, so gonna be my first choice squad this time. It's Spurs. Come on, 10 minutes.
Great tackle. Oh, so it's continuing on his way. Hey, go on, Phil. Cross. Yes. Oh, what the hell? That should have been 1-0, Correa. God damn it. Laporte.
Royce. Opportunity to cross it now.
Go back. Yes. There it is. Poor touch, but still has it. Coutinho.
Is a cheap piece.
Crap, I gave it to the way like that. Into that, sorry. Coutinho. Neymar. Correa! Boom, bottom corner. 2-0 on a 1-0 on the night.
And if you miss that, you look a little bit foolish.
It is looking good.
So the first goal, it's 1-0. The opposition will get a throw here because they've tried to play it into the wide areas and they couldn't find the player that they were trying to pick out.
Rodriguez. Laporte. Bale. Bale. The final one.
Here's the cross. Done well, the defender, to stop that cross. That will be a corner.
Tillemans.
Aaron Lennon. Almost tackled out of play there in that challenge. Rose.
Here's Rose. Spurs loses it straight to Klein. Correct. It's 2v1! Neymar! What an easy goal that was. Simple stuff. 2-0 on the night. 3-0 on aggregate. So much easier when you use the first string. I mean, I struggled in the first leg against Spurs. I had to bring Neymar on to even get that first. Yeah. First leg goal. Yeah. It's not gonna matter to Spurs now because they are definitely. The freak way out hell. There's Royce. Bang it, Royce! Oh, and he buries it! See the vision I had. I knew I could score from there, that's why. Control EP. Yeah, I think it's Lennon. Yeah, Aaron Lennon. Number 7. The shot is too good for Lloris. He has not left. He didn't get close. 15, 25, 30. Inside 15 minutes, it's gone from 1-0 to 3. Terrible shot from him. I think it was Ben Bellin? It might have been him. I don't know, I'll have to watch that back. Did I get the chance? Yeah, It was them. Who you were? Somebody, yeah.
For Liverpool, they'll be hosting Sunderland.
Yeah, I've heard a lot of supporters get excited about it, and I am as well. A very good first half.
Here we go. There's half time. They did have one shot. Who was it? Whenever you want to tell me, game. It was, in fact, Mr. Dembele. Look at that. Look at me. Look at me recognizing players. I thought it was Dembele. I don't know why I thought
it was. In that first half, I'd be delighted.
Shot up! He's kept it out. Good distance to the clearance then.
You know what? I got it right. It was Dembele. Timmons.
Coutinho.
Coutinho. Back to Bale, and he scores against his former club.
And the keeper, well, he makes a decent effort.
4-0 on aggregate. 5-0 on aggregate. It's just a demolition job.
Coutinho.
Correa. Oh, it's 5-0. See, this is what the first team can do. They are decimating Spurs. They're showing absolutely no mercy. It's 5-0 inside, and not even an hour marker has gone. This is so over. It's not funny. I mean, I have to go for more goals. I will, because of course I will. I love to win by big margins. It's as easy for my goalkeeper one. They are going bad. I'm pretty sure they're not even giving shit now. When that is the best they can do in terms of crosses, yeah, you know they're getting desperate.
Taking the heat out of the moment, the ball back to the goalkeeper. Marco Reus. Just a little too fast forward there. He's got that through clever reading of the game. The shot's on!
Yeah, I think he was offside. Yeah, he was.
Moussa Dembele.
I have no idea what they're even bothering to make substitutions. All I can guess is that maybe they're just resting those players for their weekend game. And I've given them a pretty good chance to get perhaps a consolation goal. They'll stand here. Okay. I come to you and clear.
Walker.
And blood. Kane.
Kyle Walker.
Walker.
Got it shut off now.
Wait, it's over the bar. They're even bringing off Kane. Yeah, they're resting players now. When they're bringing off Harry Kane, You know they're resting players.
He's got it away.
Actually, that's not a bad idea. Why not? Bring on Jordan Henderson. Bring on Iheanacho. And I'll bring on Origi. Put me in one. This is the wall straight away, brilliant. That's the one. Hey! Oh, there's a full-time whistle. Woo!
Yeah! That is how you do it.
And Manchester City await me in the final. Ironically, the same final as Rangers at the World Cup. Although, this one will have a different outcome. Miracle. Oh wow, it's Bayern! Why do they want it? I mean, I get easy. Done keeper sentence if it is. Yeah. See that one as their backup keeper? No, he's my backup keeper. You can't have him to be your backup keeper. He's my backup keeper. Yeah. Ooh. Let's see if I find any gems. Nope. Terrible. Not good enough. No. Absolutely not. Did you find any gems? Not good enough. Hello. Well, you are definitely looking promising. No and no. So, one is what we found. Looks like he'll be another right midfielder. Brilliant, because I haven't got enough of them. Seriously, I'm getting all right midfielders. I know Beck here is a left, but every single... Like, I'm not just them. I have... If Bale, it's Irving. I still haven't got rid of anything else. I have Mills here, and I have Brito. I don't need so many right mids. I mean, it's great to have a squad depth, but come on, this is taking it a bit too far. Anyway, next episode, I have games against Sunderland. And after the window, I have West Ham.
I am currently 20 points clear of Arsenal. I don't know who they have. Oops. Oh, I guess you're seeing the goal scores. Fair enough. Let's see who Arsenal are playing. They are playing. Watford. With Watford's defensive nature, you never know. You never know. Where are Watford in it? Wow. So much for that. That defensive nature isn't exactly doing them. Great. Heal. Both my opposition in the next episode are in the bottom five. Eve, Sunderland 16th, West Ham 2nd in the bottom. Well, we will have to wait and see if perhaps they can surprise me. You never know. Oh, I'm not going to count them out. So yeah, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Hey, don't bother watching. If you're a Liverpool fan, don't bother watching them for the rest of the season either. The season's over. We're not going to beat Dortmund. And top six is now out of the question. So, yeah. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Like if you did. Subscribe for more videos very soon. And I hope you all have a very, very nice day. I'll see you all.